And welcome back. Welcome back to Open Your Eyes. And we're about to venture off into our second segment for the morning. And you're seeing everything that's here. Yes, it's a very important topic. We've got the pro in. It's actually a health segment, herb and food that cleanse the body. In with us, Cornelius Marfield. Now, this guy is, I need to get this correct.
A naturopathic medicine.
Naturopathic doctor. Mm-hmm. Cool.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Truly. The word speaks for itself. Naturopathic deals with natural remedies. Now, indeed, in our training, we did study conventional meds. Mm-hmm. We study pharmacology. We study lifestyle-related physiology and anatomy. Mm-hmm. But a large portion of our study focused more on preventative rather than treating symptoms. Okay. And we also look at corrective measures as it relates to the human anatomy and food, herbs, and other methods that can help with the healing process.
Okay, cool.
So when you say preventative, in other words, before you need to access any medication for some sort of disease, there are things you can regularly eat or ingest to be able to prevent it, right?
You sound like the next naturopathic doctor. Excellent. indeed.
No matter who says it, whether it's natural medicine or formal medicine, it always comes back to what I see on this table, fruits and vegetables.
And vegetables?
Indeed.
Fruits and veg.
Indeed.
Cornelia, tell me, you have been in this line of work for so long. It's fascinating that in a country where we are rich with so many fruits and so many vegetables, people don't consume what is just the required amount per day.
I think a lot of it is misinformation and lack of information, because whenever you empower a person's mind, then the decisions follow. And I think we have not been taught enough, maybe, about the benefits, which are some of the reasons why we are here today, to teach not just that you eat fruits and vegetables, but what are the benefits. You notice I have my good friend with us, and he has different organs in him, and those organs are critical, and we are dealing with cleansing, and they told me cooling drinks. So the cleansing organs basically are your colon, your liver, basically, and then your skin, and of course a portion of it is the lungs, but the large eliminating organs are your skin, your liver, and your colon. And if we can keep those clean using these types of food that were made in the creation for us, then I believe that we can see good health, and we can once we understand the benefit and the interaction between food and our body, then I think we are more readily ready to consume it.
If you had to identify one item on this table that you would tell everybody at home, start eating this and start eating it regularly, which one would it be?
I think, you know, things like pineapple, or
one
on the table.
One, because it's a heavy hitter that, you know, you've got to get at least this one.
Yeah, half the be moringa. No, I did brought moringa, but if from the fruits, locally, because you notice I brought lone local stuff. Yes. I didn't bring apple and grapes, but I would say pineapple is very good, because pineapple having bromelain that is good for the digestive system. It has in a lot of the minerals that are good as electrolyte, as we'll discuss right now.
Ooh.
This was prepared last night. I made it in the form of a tea. And you can sample it. And what we do, we take things that we take for granted, the skin. And we just throw it away. But under that skin, there is a lot of the micro nutrients that are still valuable to our body. So what we do, we draw it as a tea, and you get this as an ale. This is a good sport drink.
That's just water and pineapple.
Pineapple with a little bit of sweetening, and you make it as a tea for 5 minutes, and it pulls out all of those natural minerals. So it's a good electrolyte.
So when
so you
say
boil it,
that's what I was going to.
You, we normally Belizeans, we typically make it in the form of a juice.
I was
fermented.
That's one way you can prepare it, but from a nutritional and a more health conscious preparation, this would be ideal.
But
it's quick to make too.
Put the skin in a pot, put water, put it on the stove,
boil it for
15 minutes,
and just put a little sugar to sweeten it, and you consume that for the morning.
Would you recommend honey?
Yeah, honey, brown sugar. No? Yeah, depending on your condition. If you're a diabetic, evidently you want to watch how much of what you put in there as a sweetener. But it's excellent.
And I was excited when I saw that, because you know, people make the pineapple juice different way.
Right.
I grew up with the fermented in the
water.
Yes. And so I said, oh, we're doing something right.
This
is a different technique.
And it's good. It's excellent, Marlene. Yeah. And you should try it afterwards. And like I said, the nutritional benefits are awesome. A good electrolyte, especially in this hot time climate that we're dealing with. You know, you're working out in the sun, walking in the sun, you get a lot of this consume. Another good friend of mine is the infused lime water, where we put cucumber, we put lime, and we put some mint.
Yeah.
Again, things that are locally grown. Yeah.
Okay.
Nice mint leaf. You know that gives that aromatic smell,
and
but
natural mint is very strong.
And it's very good for your stomach, again, for digestive issue. It's good to clean the colon. It's good for getting out some of the bad bacteria.
Yeah.
And it settles the stomach on a whole. It soothes it. Mm-hmm. Very good.
So let's start in order here, right? So the first thing you have here, this isn't included in your natural mint.
Yes. no, Marlene.
Is this what you're calling
infused lime water.
Okay, tell me why this is one of your recommendations.
Why? Because it's good, again, to hydrate. It's good to cleanse. This is a good friend of the liver. 10 days of this, you drink it periodically throughout the day.
What periodically? How many times?
Normally, for a typical average mug, which is about almost twice the size, I will do one whole cucumber, I will do two lime, and I will do a handful of mint. I chop them up, dice it up, soak it in the water overnight, and then I could put it in my 150 baht water, refrigerate it at work, and drink it throughout the day.
Okay.
Wow. What it does, it also stimulates the peristalsis movement, which is that extra push to get those products that have been fecally compacted in the colon
to come out.
So it also does, it's a friend of the liver, so it cleans the liver. It's a natural liver cleanser, and it's also a cooling drink.
Cool. Because cucumber is very cooling.
Have a smell of it.
Smell it.
You get a good aroma.
So
and there's no sugar added to this.
This is just infused water is very popular. This is just that one more recipe people can use.
Right.
So let's talk about the individual ingredients that you have here. Cucumber, lime, and mint. Why this combination?
All right, this is a good cleanser.
Lime is. Okay.
From when I was small, I remember Dr. Roca, a good friend of my grandmother, used to say, you want to solve these problems, just drink a lot of lime every day. We always hear an apple a day keep the doctor away. Lime a day could do a lot. Now, we have this thing in Belize, you know, cut your nature.
It's a lot of acid.
Let me clarify that. This is only bad for your stomach if you have ulcer, because it does has a low pH when it enters the digestive system. But amazingly, once it goes through the process of digestion, it becomes alkalinized. So it's actually good to fight cancer. This will make your blood alkaline. Isn't that amazing? Out of your body, it has a pH that is low, which means it's acidic. But once it gets assimilated into the system, it becomes alkalized. Do your research. I challenge you.
Which is why lemon water is so good. Lime water here in
Belize. They are good first cousin. So it's very good. It's also good to clean the liver. Cucumber is more cooling. This is 95% water. But again, under the skin, and notice we have maintained the skin in the, again, a lot of magnesium, manganese, potassium, calcium, things that are loaded in there, and you just soak and get out everything.
So the nutrients come out of these into the water.
That's right. It's called infused. It's infused in it.
And then the mint?
Yes.
And the mint, well, like I said earlier, is good for the digestive system. We know this when we are small. Ginger and mint. When you have peanut belly, Granny takes some mint tea and makes it for you. Make some ginger tea, makes it for you. Excellent.
Okay. Perfect.
Nice.
All right.
And let me say one thing for the record, because now we get a lot of this. This can be grown easily in your
but
sometimes we get it from Mexico and their spirit. So what I suggest, you take some apple cider vinegar and then clean it, soak it in the apple cider vinegar for 5 minutes, because this has a very tough non-porous skin, so the chemicals do not necessarily go into it easily. But it sits on top, and you want to clean that out, because obviously that's not best for your stomach. That's a
and
point
with
there
infused water, you want to do that with whatever you're putting in there.
That makes sense, right?
That makes a lot of sense.
Then another cooling cleansing drink, and we talk about, I didn't mention
favorite.
Of the kidneys. This is excellent for the kidneys. This is as good as cranberry juice.
My favorite.
Ooh. Good for UTI, and this has
cranberry is your favorite?
This has a little bit of the
ginger.
Tell me what is this?
Turmeric.
Turmeric,
yes.
Yellow ginger and ginger.
Very, very good. Excellent. Again, good. These are good cleansers and excellent to clean out the lining, especially for UTI.
Yes.
Again, good for the digestive system. So a little bit. These are very strong. Put a little bit. Again, we can sample at the end. I made these pre-made them,
you know,
so we're not, you know, kill time, but It gives good color to your food, and it's also very good to fight cancer.
Okay.
Very good to fight cancer.
Let's take a moment to talk about this little special one here, right?
Turmeric.
So we've been eating yellow ginger, mm-hmm. and especially depending on what part of the country you're from, probably a lot more, for so long. And now it has popped up as a mainstream health food.
You see that?
Right?
Right. So we are in the market now. Everybody.
So we call it yellow ginger. They call it turmeric.
Yeah. It's the same, basically the same component. It's a first cousin to the actual local ginger. Yeah. But this, whenever you see your food is colorful, it means it has what we call antioxidants.
Yes. Okay.
And those are substances that fight against cancer, carcinogenic compounds. Yeah. So this is excellent to fight a lot of the cancer that we have.
So that's what the claim to fame for turmeric is now?
And it's also excellent for inflammation. We have, I do therapies too in my field, and a lot of people come with inflammatory problem, and I tell them, you take this and you mix it with this. Pineapple also has an anti-inflammatory agent, and you make 1 inch of a turmeric every evening, and you make about half a pineapple, and you blend that together. Very good for all of these gout and ouch pain that we have. All right, now we have to find the culprit, caused by uric acid, which caused by a lot of protein intake. We might want to reduce or eliminate certain food, but the truth is, as a form of easing the pain, it's very good. It's a big thing, inflammatory disease.
So turmeric or yellow ginger.
So you put a little bit with the watermelon. Watermelon is a good diuretic too. It helps flushing out the kidney. So you tend to urinate a lot.
My favorite.
Again, cranberry if you can afford it. But I wanted to focus more on things that we can get locally.
Yeah.
And that's my
preference. And I find cranberry juice too acidic. I would prefer this.
The watermelon. Right.
And the only time cranberry is really highly recommended if the doctor diagnoses you with UTI, urinary tract infection, because you want that acidic nature, because the bacteria cannot exist in that environment. Oh. And hence it's good for that consumption. But under normal circumstances, a glass of watermelon juice is good, and you try not to put sugar, especially if you're a diabetic. As a diabetic, I would prefer you to eat it this way than this way, because because whenever you pulverize fruits, you extract the fructose and glucose and the other,
so you get sweeter.
You get sweeter in concentration. That's just a rule when you juice. So it's best to eat the whole fruit. Not only that, when you eat the whole fruit, like if I squeeze orange and I eat the whole orange, I get the pulp, I get the endocarp, I get the fiber, I get the whole shibam with it, but when I'm just squeezing the juice,
it's
I'm just
sugar.
So that's just a food for thought.
This is just blended watermelon
with some little bit of ginger.
That's it.
Yeah, and that's good for the kidneys. So this one is good for the liver cooling. This one is good for the kidney cooling. Remember, we are talking about detoxifying organs.
Did you add sweetener to this?
This has no sweetener because this is sugar, baby.
Yeah.
And by nature, it's sweet. But you could add if you want.
Taste.
I don't see you put 2 spoons of sugar to that it will kill you. Right? I mean, that's acceptable.
Not too much.
And maybe brown sugar.
Too sweet.
Put a little ice. It's very cooling, like I said, in this hot weather.
And then we have
next up.
It's a herb. Anybody know what is herb? If I can see if Marlene know herbs.
Come on.
If it's any kind of bitters, I fought my whole life not to drink
this. This is the typical Cerasin.
Do
you know this is sweet?
Yes, if you the fruit this, inside.
The fruit
the
is sweet, but the leaf is bitter. That's amazing.
Yes.
But let me tell you a good way to prepare it so Marlene don't make up her face. I boil this for 10 minutes. Who could tell me what you think is in there? Raisins.
A raisin in there?
Raisins.
And that's for the sweetener.
This is for sweetener, but this is for energy. This is good for us men too.
We need to taste this one.
This is a good energizer because it cleans the pipelining, it cleans the blood, it cleans the reproductive organ. It's good for female too, especially around your monthly.
Okay. So
it's a blood cleanser too.
So this is Cerasi.
And just a little bit, a handful of Cerasi in a pot of water with about a handful of raisin.
With raisins.
And this is
Can
it right
it?
Here.
So smell it,
yeah,
yes.
smell it. And it's quite nice. It's not as bitter as you are as making it.
Normally, when Cerasi, you know, from Dong South PG, and they would put that on the pot, they're like,
Yeah, because
then you don't want to taste it. This one, because of the reasons that it smells
one of the one of the rules with wet, we try to make the food palatable.
Not bad.
It smells like regular tea.
And it doesn't taste too bad.
Yeah. Not too bad. But it's good for you. I mean, yes. I don't deny
good
that
for
much.
You. This is old school. Do you remember from when we were young, they gave us Cerasi.
You had to drink that on a Saturday. That's your thing.
Cerasi and Yalicina.
Yes.
No, it's pretty good. Like I say, it's an energizer and we can look more at that later on.
So what parts of the body are we talking about here? How does Cerasi actually help? It's blood cleaning?
It's a blood cleanser. Mm-hmm. When you clean your blood, you're also going to consequently build the blood. Mm-hmm. Whenever you clean the blood, you enhance the building process. Okay. Mm-hmm. So maybe this with some beet juice afterwards is excellent.
That's the
blood. Uh-huh. The blood is key because blood is life. Blood is what feeds all the organs. So we want to keep those cleansed. Now, on that note, I do make another herbs. Okay. And I put it in capsule for Marlene because she would not be able to consume neem naturally. Neem and jackass bitters is in this one.
But neem is,
is very
anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, antibiotic. Uh-huh.
It's an antimicrobial. It's good for fungus, bacteria, viruses.
Yes.
Excellent to clean the blood. I use this with diabetics
too. I've used that already.
Because
the oil.
Anti-glycemic. It's good for external topical use as well. Yes. The oil, you have soaps in it. A whole lot of stuff with neem. Neem is grown locally. That's why I brought it. Yes. This is one of my favorite seller. Uh-huh. And you get it at the health food store.
Yes.
And you see. So I have an alternative. And if you want to spend a little extra.
It really does smell like black tea. Like if you could drink black tea, then... And John will try it and
question.
Tell you.
Yeah, we'll try them, definitely. But I wanted to know, especially, bringing up your family, these are some of the things I want to teach them, like I was taught. Mm-hmm. But the thing that I don't remember is how often we had to drink it. Yeah. So for this, how often would you say,
For Cerasi, I would say maybe once a week. Sina was a little stronger on us because I think Granny didn't really understand portion. So she take a lot of Sina leaf and boy.
Ten a week, she gave us ten a week. One bar.
But I brought something for Plus TV crew today. We made this personally at our clinical spa in Belmont. Okay. And this is Sina with Epsom salt. This is a little kick for the morning, gentlemen.
A little kick
for the digestive system. Many times, most of us don't use
Epsom salt.
Yes,
Sina
and Sina leaves. This is one dosage just to kind of give the colon a little push in the morning. So you would drink it first thing in the morning, nice and warm, and you should evacuate by 5 minutes time, and you should have a good evacuation. I'm just trying.
I'll take one.
So this is very good. We thought this
one. When you guys decide the morning shift, this guy says it's helpful. Okay, but Epsom salt
is a good laxative.
Good.
Okay,
it's
I
a
didn't
good
know
laxative.
That.
It's a very good laxative. Actually, when I do liver cleansing, like people who come with liver issue, we would recommend you take a teaspoon to a glass of water on 5 minutes interval, four times prior to the actual liver cleanse, and you would be amazed how you go to the bathroom.
All right.
Epsom salt, very good laxative.
Okay,
it's not a strong portion.
If you are regular, and this is one of the key things that doctor will ask you, a regular bowel movement, whether it's one day, every two days, whatever. Yeah. How do you know when you need this?
Okay, you see what you said just now? It's not every other day. We should evacuate after 8 hours.
Wow.
Uh-huh. I'll give you some information here. See this colon? Mm-hmm. This colon is 5 feet in length. It has a transit period of about 2 hours there to get stuff out after digestion and churning, which takes about 5 hours. Normally take about 3 hours to do your blending in the stomach. It takes another 2 hours for absorption and another 3 to evacuate. If I ate 6 this morning, I should have an urge by this afternoon to evacuate. And if I eat midday, I should have an urge to evacuate this evening. So at least twice a day. If you do not go twice a day, you already consider constipated. We have the conception that constipated means you're in the bathroom and
you lift two
barbells and okay, let people get the stuff out. That's another category of constipation.
But
constipation means that you're not having regular bowel movement.
Okay.
And that has different subdivision. If you don't go after every other day, you're definitely
something's wrong.
And what we see will come out give us an idea of why you don't want it inside too long.
Yeah.
Because that's your sewer system, And you don't want your sewer system clogged up too long.
Okay. We understand.
So right. Let's move on, right? So let me just ask and you, though, how often should you do it?
A typical washing like this is if you find that you're not moving your bowel regularly.
Okay.
But if you're clogged up, the doctor say you're constipated.
Yes.
I had a friend who hadn't used the bathroom for 6 days. I quickly put him on this.
Mm-hmm.
This is a colon cleanse. Now, this has local and American herbs in it. Mm-hmm. This is much more expensive. This is a concoction I learned at the hospital. I studied in the States, and I thought I would bring down this.
Bentonite,
so it has in bentonite as an antitoxin. Mm-hmm. It has cascara sagrada as a laxative.
Mm-hmm.
It has in diatomaceous earth, which is also an antitoxin.
Yeah.
And the major guy that does the job, the psyllium husk, it's a bulky husk from the plant that has the ability to swell in water.
That's
so you make this like a shake and this will go in. Now this won't give you diarrhea. Like Sina could give you diarrhea. This will give you a bulky evacuation. It's like you're putting a grater in that.
Pushing it out.
And getting out the stuff.
Everything.
And the antitoxin is pulling out the toxins.
And is it like, is it instant or an hour or two?
Normally when you take this with water, in about 3 hours, you feel the urge.
Oh. Okay.
And you should take it twice a day, so you should go twice a day.
This 5 minutes,
plan your
not
day
3 hours.
Accordingly.
And we sell this right at the health food store, by the way. Most of these products, our Moringa, etc., right at Santos Diaz Health Food Store, and we have it at our clinical spa in Belmopan, okay. in front of Brody's. Food for thought. Now, on another note, I went to a pharmacy this week, and he said, I told him I was coming on this show, and he gave me this to advertise. This is something that they sell very economical. It's a combination of tamarind and prunes. It's actually a capsule that they sell at the pharmacy. All right, it's a capsule, and this is another alternative. It's called Tamarind LX. It's pure, it's all natural. It's tamarind that is combined with prunes.
Well, I know prunes is good.
Yes. Tamarind is
but
also,
I didn't know
yes,
the
if
same
you
thing.
If you drink a lot of tamarind juice, you will have an urge to go to the bathroom.
It's also, I didn't know that.
Yes, and it's also a cooling drink.
Yeah.
Because we talk about cooling drinks to cool you off.
Okay.
All right. So that's very good too.
Let's move on to my good friend, the pineapple.
Well, like we said earlier, pineapple
is boiled
and made as a tea and can be drunk morning and evening, preferably drunk before you eat. Maybe 20 minutes. So about 20 minutes you take it, and I recommend it as a sports drink. You can cool it and you can drink it hot as a tea, or you could refrigerate it after it's boiled. And it lasts long.
Will it ferment like it normally does?
No, I was about to tell you, it won't ferment. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't ferment. No, if you add sugar, you might create fermentation if you leave it out in the heat.
Okay.
Once it's refrigerated, it stays just like any other sports drink that might have in some fructose or so in it.
Okay. So this is, you said it's putting back electrolytes into your body.
Basically.
Is that what you said?
It's also good prolytic enzymes in it. Bromelain is the main
prolytic enzymes
are another word for helping with the digestive system, the flora and the fauna.
Okay.
So your digestive system tend to work. Sometimes it's too acidic, sometimes it's too alkaline, sometimes you have too much bacteria. So what does this help mobilize
and then level
keep
it off.
Basically, balance.
And it has to be delicious. It's pineapple.
You should taste it.
I will.
Take a drink.
I'm really tempted for this one. This one is like right up my alley.
And then we have coconut water, because remember we are talking about this. So I kind of buy this morning while I was coming on.
That's a fancy one.
Unfortunately,
right?
I kind of abruptly had to break some of it through. The car drinker, I didn't even get a chance to drink it. But this is excellent. This is a good diuretic again. Very good for the kidneys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Good to clean out the kidneys. Good for cooling the body. Helps with regulating the temperature.
Well, no,
good
for
can you drink too much coconut water?
Yeah. Good question.
I think sometimes if you overdo things, you might go to the bathroom. Mango is in season. Mango is excellent. Mm-hmm. It has in vitamin C, this, but if you take too much mango, you start to have, you will see the color.
But if you're diabetic, you can't have mango.
Well, we know that because it's one of the higher glycemic index fruit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But on a normal person, you don't want to eat too much either. So I would say if you do coconut water every day, it could be very good for your kidneys. But you don't want to be drinking it all day, evidently.
For me, after working out, for me, I go to coconut water and I feel so good.
But if your kidney is not working properly, you can drink more of it.
Okay.
But the younger one, I want to emphasize the younger coconut water for kidney dysfunction.
Yes. Oh. Not the
See,
one.
You won't know that. In Belize City, we just buy the gallon.
Right.
What is this?
Well, again, my soy milk turnover, but so, they asked me about...
Where is this driver? We need to bring out the license.
But soy, because when I was asked to come on the show, they asked me to talk about cleansing and cooling drink.
Yeah.
There is another issue that particularly women experience in their later years, and we call it menopause, right?
Yeah.
Menopause. Yeah. Right? And during that time is when your estrogen is dipping and your progesterone is a little higher. So what this has in is having phytoestrogen. Mm-hmm. Phyto means plant, and estrogen mimicking the natural one we have.
Oh,
and so it helps to balance the hormone. And it also having isoflavoids and flavonoids, some other good hormonal-like substances. So soy milk would be recommended for women who are going between premenopausal or going through menopause.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so I just thought I'd show that out since we were talking about cooling drinks.
No,
as
it
well.
Is true.
Because
yeah,
there's a lot of heat that is generated.
A lot, yeah.
There's a lot of heat generated, and you know, it could help with the problem.
Okay.
So just thought I'd show that out.
So any soy product with soy milk is one of the easiest ones.
It's easier, and it's very easy to make. You take this, don't try to cook it. You'll cook all night and you'll guess well done. That's interesting. I remember one of my friends, I told him, get some soybeans and use it, and he said, they boil the beans all night. And the beans wouldn't soft. This is not used for that kind of usage.
Beans. How do you use it?
You soak this. You take 1 pound in a mug of water, 1 gallon of water. Mm. You soak this overnight. And then you take off the skin the next day. And you will blend it up. And then you take a cheesecloth and you squeeze out of that milk. And then you boil it for about 20 minutes and you put in your... whatever, cinnamon,
flavor.
You flavor it with your, you know, nutmeg, sugar, you'd be surprised.
So put it in a crock pot.
No, you're all night.
What do you do with the
trash? Some people make vegetarian meats, you know, there's a lot of things that nothing should waste, you know. Yes. One of the things Rani teach me, not make nothing waste on the table, so you'd be amazed. Some people do patties from it, etc.
All right, so
time to sampling now.
Pick your drink.
And then, of course, lastly, we have our more. Oh, no, I have two more products I need to advertise.
Uh-huh.
This is also good for women. This is a natural beauty herbal tea that we make in Belmopan.
Natural beauty herbal tea.
Herbal tea. Because health is beauty and beauty is health.
That's right.
All
right.
Fever grass. I don't happy with you.
And fever grass is also, by the way, very good to cool the system.
Yes,
all this heat and stuff. It has a cooling effect on it. So fever grass, soursop. This is a combination of local and foreign herb. We have red clover. Google red clover. Mm-hmm. And red clover is excellent. Most of the hormonal pills that they sell, some of it having red clover.
Mm-hmm.
So all natural is a cousin to the periwinkle. Mm-hmm. Also a very good anti-cancer herb.
Horsetail
is grown locally. It looked like a little tail and had our plant and it kind of cracked it. You could whoop somebody.
No animals were hurt.
Yes. It's like smaller version to bamboo. Very thin. And it's grown right here in Belize.
Okay.
And this is very good for stones, hard steel, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
So I just throw that out too.
Eliminate cysts, relieve menstrual cramps, cleanse the uterus and kidneys. My God.
Yes. So it's a herb that we sell, and then we have our kidney flush. All right, again. So these are just some
things. And we know that we have issues with kidney disease in this country as well.
Yes,
so this is also good for people to
And of course, control your sugar and your hypertension. Because those are the two major culprits for kidney problem.
All right, John, take your pick. What are you drinking?
And moringa. Don't forget my moringa, right? That's my number one.
Oh, moringa is
Yes. Go ahead.
I'm going to pick first.
So you
pick.
You want to try
infused water.
Yeah. Like, I just infused it last night. It's and I did it late, so I don't know how strong it is. But you guys cheer up.
Taste this. Cheers. Smells good.
Yeah. It's not strong. It's pretty good. It has that minty taste. It has that cooling effect. And it's good for the digestive system.
I like this.
You like it?
It's the perfect, the way that I like my drink to be blend.
Yeah.
It's not too sweet.
Right.
Yeah.
It's not too bland.
Mm-hmm.
It's like right there.
All right.
I love it.
You
it's
like
very
it?
Very good, yes.
All right, all right. And then, well, I need a cup for my watermelon. I love watermelon. And I want the gentleman.
We're sure one cup.
Definitely, we want our gentleman to drink this too. Watermelon is very good. I love watermelon juice. It's one of my favorite.
Yeah. I surely want to taste this one.
Okay, you want to do this
one? Well, we're out of cups at this time, out of time. So some of this will happen off camera.
Yes.
But Cornelio, if people would like to get more information from you, how can they get in touch?
All right, contact number is 625-4231. 625-4231. I have a very active Facebook page, Cornelio. Yeah. Health Vision Marfield, Cornelia Health Vision Marfield. And you could email me too, Kermarf, C-O-R-M-A-R-F at yahoo.com. My main thing is...
Sorry.
You were... Does it taste like black tea?
625-4231.
Yes, like tea.
It's good.
Like, I really didn't expect this taste.
Serious?
Yes. Really didn't.
This is a good little trick. And the key to this is not to use too much sarrasin.
Okay.
A handful to about 3 glasses of water and then a handful of raisin.
Okay.
Let it boil and let it sit overnight. It's very good energy drink. I promise
there
you, gentlemen.
There you go. Took one for the team. Good for you. Right? But thank you, Cornelia, once again. This was a very interesting segment. All of these things you can find at your market. You can definitely try at home as well. We're going to go ahead and take a break, and we'll be back in a few. Stay tuned.